Hey everyone, so one of the channels that I watch is by Rand Siegel, and he's a great web designer. I learn a ton from him, and it's called Flux, and recently he had a video about improving landing page conversion rates, and he was focusing it on his specific, on one of the products of his, and so I thought, well, maybe I should apply some of those concepts and thoughts that he was thinking about, how he changed his, to our app. And our app is Happy Plant. So I thought what I would do is just explain a little bit of what I did and just kind of show sort of like a before and after like he did. Here is what the app looked like. What the landing page looked like. And it eventually became this. And so I learned a lot from him. I thought I would just explain sort of the changes step by step in case this could be helpful. All right, so this was the before, this was the after, and I just thought I would kind of go step by step and just explain what I did, why I made the change, and yeah, let's just see. So I think as Rand was saying, that you should change the title should really highlight the key benefits of someone, of your audience. And so in our space, we're not after the B2B customers. So it's not so much about being able to do something three times faster, but more I wanted to touch upon the aspirations, I think, that of our users. And so because now we have a lot of reviews with our app, you can get some sort of words and ideas from your audience in terms of their language, what they like. And so that's what I put here. So in the past, I just wrote this thing like keep your plants happy, watering app to remember to water plants. So very keyword focused and sort of this sort of happy feeling, keep your plants happy. Actually, not so many of our audience are really talking about the happiness part, but more just like, yeah, I need a simple app to water my plants. So here it is. Water your plants, and that's it. And watch your babies grow. So that comes with sort of the fun factor that we tried to put into this, because a lot of the apps in the gardening space are very technical, and so we wanted to make something that's more lightweight and just fun. So the idea of your plants are really your babies. So that's where that comes from. So very quickly, you can see water your plants, watch your babies grow. And that's kind of the gist of Happy Plant, is that you set reminders to water your plant and then you watch it grow. So here, the text here, Happy Plant is watering an app, is a watering app that reminds you to water your green buddies so they can keep living healthy. Everyone forgets to water their plants, we're all guilty, but with a simple notification, you can remind yourself and keep your green buddies for a long time. Get your plants drunk on water. So with this, I was trying to get to the point of, I was trying to make it very fun. And so I had this idea, especially with marketing, like, yeah, let's talk about, let's get drunk on water, let's do fun stuff like that. And I also wanted to play towards that sympathy side of, it's a common problem that people do forget to water their plants. So I was thinking by that, it could be, something, it gives a sense of an approachable app. I ended up changing the text a little bit just to make it much shorter. And I think to the point where I said, it's so easy to forget to water your plants, but it doesn't have to be. Happy Plant reminds you to water plants through game-like notifications, plant selfies, and time-lapse videos, so you can watch your happy plants grow, baby, grow. So this was my attempt to just make things a little bit shorter, and just really, I wanted to highlight the features of what our app can do, because I think sometimes people are just looking for, sort of keywords of, what can this do? How's it going to be different? So I thought time-lapse video, that's different from our competitors, so I wanted to make sure that gets up there. The call to action is, if you click this, then you are directed directly to the app itself, so you can go download it. So just just kept that as was. But here I added some stuff below. So I wanted to get, I brought in the five-star feature, because that plays in, that's a big thing when it comes to apps. You know, you're more likely to download something if it has 5 stars versus 2 stars. So I want to bring this out there, and I'm not necessarily saying it's we are a 5-star app, although in some countries I think we are. But it's overall it's impossible to be a complete 5-star app, I think. But I just wanted to put some of the features or some of the stats. We've been downloaded over 80,000 times. I think the number is more or less around there, and featured in 20 countries. So especially at the beginning of the year, we got a lot of recognition from Apple. So that was pretty cool. And then on the right side, I don't have a video to explain how to use the app, but more just wanted to put some photos of it just to give a sense of, you know, this is what the app looks like. So that's sort of the main hero section. And then right below it, you can see here what I had before. You actually had to scroll down. And I think I wanted to, you know, touch that this was a featured app at the time. But what I want to do is shorten it up, because I thought Rand makes a good point of, you know, show some testimonials or something that gives some sort of, you know, substance that can demonstrate that other people are happy with this product. And so what I did is this is a 13-inch monitor. So I imagine, you know, you're going to be able to see more if you're on a bigger screen. But here I just listed a bunch of reviews so far. And then here I put, these are some of the publishers that have written a post about us. So I put that down here. I actually started it up here, but when I put those icons here, all these reviews go down. And I was thinking, you know, what's more important for people to see? Do they want to see reviews from real people, or would they rather just see these logos that are kind of, you know, most companies, or you just see these all the time? So I was thinking, yeah, this makes it feel a little bit more personal, and it's coming from real people. So, okay, so that's my redesign of the hero section. Okay, did not mean for this to be so long, but yeah, I'm getting used to this. But I think I wanted to make some points across to just kind of show to give a thought of what I was thinking beforehand and how I ended up changing based on the video that I saw from Rand. So Rand, thanks a lot for that video. One thing that he did point out that we haven't done a good job, or we actually weren't doing it before, is analytics and trying to understand optimization. So you can change the design with these thoughts, so what I've just done, but to really understand, are more people clicking on the button or taking action, I need to set some of these measurements up. So I've done this before using Google Analytics, but I just haven't done it on this particular website. So I think what I'll do is I'll put some goals, we can call them, on just the buttons to see if they're being clicked a little bit more. And I think one thing I can see is the time that is spent on a page. So I think if it goes up, then there's a good indicator that you know, something's resonating a little bit more, or at least because I've shrunk in the top part, it might be more inviting for someone to actually spend the moments to read those few lines and maybe scroll down more, rather than just seeing more text and just like being almost overwhelmed and then they want to go somewhere else. So, all right. So that was sort of my attempt to redesign it, and I'm happy with how it came out, and now we'll see how it goes. And if you have an iPhone or iPad and you have some plants, which you should, check out Happy Plant. So, okay, thanks a lot, and hope this was helpful.
Papa?
Oui?
J'ai un truc à te dire.